dance of caring persons, which demonstrates how senses can be lost and found with courage, communication, compassion, commitment, competency, and care given by the staff of the NHS.
Love. I was going to bore you with a story that started with, I was in Barcelona, and I was walking down in a dark alley at night, and there was a ballroom dancing class going on, and the door was just shutting, and the lady said, come in quick. So then she shut the door, and we got on with the class. Oh, I didn't speak any Spanish, didn't much, wasn't much of a ballroom dancer. But with a strong lead, it really made me think of when I was in physiotherapy after my head injury. That would have been a great way of guiding someone through the movements, you know, and it has that personal touch, supported sort of thing. And that was kind of the seed for this a bit. So, yeah, thank you all for coming.
Wonderful artist that works with us, and he has a piece called Cahedia that will be in our next show.
It's on YouTube, it's a mind expanding cityscape. Change your life.
It will. Change mine. And also, for the Dance of the Caring Persons, I don't know if Dr. Sally Hardy would like to say something about what you've been developing with Xavier.
There's an article on your chair that we've written, and working at London South Bank, we train people to be the next generation of NHS, hopefully, carers. And Xavier has been working with us over the last year, bringing a much more creative method and means of understanding to the professional trainees that we've got. And as you can see, there's just a whole new dimension that's been brought to the university through his artwork, through his ability and willingness to collaborate, try new mediums. And the work has just continued to blossom, and we've now we've been working with Encore.
Yeah, thank you to
as
the
our
Encore
first company in residence. So we've had an artist in residence, and now we have a wonderful company in residence to work with us as well. That's
on Monday
sure
we'll have a world.
That we've got arts and humanities definitely on the agenda.
Sure.
Yeah. So thank you.